السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم. Brothers and sisters, we continue the explanation of the 40 ahadith on zakah. And the topic بإذن الله تعالى in this short video, the topic of whether one has to pay zakah on gold and silver jewelry that the sister might be making use of. We find the famous hadith of Amr ibn Shu'ayb عن أبيه عن جده أن امرأة أتت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, that this woman had come to the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم with her little daughter, and on the hands of her daughter there were two bangles of gold, مسكتان من ذهب. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم saw this and then he asked her, do you pay the zakah on these two bangles? And so she said, no. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, would you be happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts upon the hands two bangles of fire on the day of judgment? And then this woman had taken the bangles and she threw them away. Brothers and sisters, this famous hadith reported in the Sunan of Imam al-Tirmidhi and Nasa'i and others. This hadith, brothers and sisters, the scholars have a great debate with regards to its authenticity. It's the most important hadith which proves that one has to pay zakah upon gold and silver jewelry. But the issue is the authenticity of this hadith. We find that some of the ulama state that it is sahih. Sheikh Ahmed Shakir, Ibn al-Mulaqin, Imam al-Sana'ani and others of the opinion that it is sahih. Other scholars of the opinion that it reaches the level of hasan, acceptability. And from amongst those scholars, Imam al-Nawawi, Sheikh al-Albani, rahimahullah. We have other scholars, in fact, most of the ulama of ahadith are of the opinion that this hadith in reality is weak. From amongst the ulama, Imam al-Shafi'i, Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali, Imam al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah. And he said, لا يصح في الباب شيء, that there is absolutely no hadith with regards to the topic of zakah being an obligation upon gold and silver jewelry, which is authentic. And so there's this great debate amongst the ulama with regards to this hadith. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amatullah, what about the opinions of the ulama with regards to this mas'ala? Sister Sumayya asks, I have this gold ring, I have these gold earrings, I have this necklace of gold or silver. Do I need to sort out the zakah on this? We say that there are generally two famous opinions of the ulama. The first one being that yes, sister, you have to sort out zakah, 2.5% with regards to this gold and silver jewelry. Remember, brothers and sisters, we are not talking about the value of that jewelry. The value of the jewelry might be super high, but we are talking about the gold content weight of that jewelry. 2.5% of that one has to sort out in zakah. And this is the opinion of the Hanafi scholars, Imam al-Sana'ani, Ibn Hazm, Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh Uthaymeen, and Sheikh al-Albani, rahimahullah. What's their proof? What's their dalil? Their dalil is this hadith that we just mentioned. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, would you like that you wear what? You wear two bangles of fire on Yawmul Qiyamah. So sort out the zakah on gold and silver jewelry. That's opinion number one. Opinion number two is the opinion of the majority of ulama, the Shafi'i scholars, the Hanbali scholars, the Maliki scholars, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, that great Umayyad dynasty ruler, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, Ibn al-Qayyim and others. Majority of the ulama state that no, sister, you do not need to pay any zakah on gold or silver jewelry. Why? They said, number one, this hadith that you are using as your proof that she has to, the hadith is weak. Number two, they state, the default rule is that there's no obligation upon me until proved to be an obligation. Number three, the basic rule is that my clothing, my cell phone, my car, my house, I do not pay zakah on this. Anything that I make use of is not zakatable. And so the jewelry that the sister makes use of, the silver and gold jewelry that she uses to the wedding or wherever else it might be, thus it should also follow that rule, and thus it should not not be zakatable. We also find authentic from about 5 of the companions of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam that they were of the opinion that there's no zakah upon gold and silver jewelry. And this is also the opinion of our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Hassan al-Basri, he states that we do not know from the khulafa that they ever obliged zakah upon jewelry. Ya Abdullah, ya Amat Allah, after discussing this matter from both ends of the spectrum, after discussing the opinions and the evidences and whether this hadith is authentic or not, yourself, Sumayya Ahmed Ilyas, the husband of Sumayya or whoever else it might be, what do you do with regards to this matter? What's the safest option? The safest option, no doubt, brothers and sisters, is because there's debate amongst the ulama. Some say pay zakah on gold and silver jewelry. Some say do not pay, you don't have to pay. What's the safest thing for you to do? The safest thing, walhamdulillah, is for you to sort out zakah on this gold and silver jewelry. That's the best thing. It's the safest thing, and it's the matter which would earn you closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Abdullah, Ya Amat Allah, and that's the final message that we leave you with, and that is be on the safe side. Be on the safe side and sort out a mere 2.5%. It's very, very little, walhamdulillah, and Allah will give you barakah, masha'Allah, tabarakallah. Hayyakum Allah, until we meet again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.